But to give them more of an idea about how it could look, I've got access to something similar. It's not brick for brick identical, but I think it will get their creative pulses racing.
Love the door.
Ooh, that's clever.
Wow.
I knew that you would like it. I mean, it is. It's incredible, isn't it?
Yeah, that pool.
Look at those views across the dunes.
You know, this is a very, very modern villa, obviously. What do you think?
It's absolutely gorgeous.
I knew you'd say that.
Who wants something modern?
No, you're just saying.
No, I'm just saying what he said he wanted.
You know, it's all very clean, very minimal. You've got a bedroom in there.
I like the staircase.
I love the staircase.
Like spirals, that's beautiful.
Dressing room. Uh-huh. Big, flashy, bling-bling bathroom.
It's gorgeous, that pool.
I know.
You can see almost as far as Faroe Airport and the islands, you know.
Come and have a look. Back in again. Now, what is going through your mind? Because we've just come from a house that you were saying, I want it, I want to put an offer in on it, this is the one, to another very viable option, but very, very different.
I'm still very, very keen on the other one. I loved everything about it. The only downside, and this was obviously something Caroline brought up, was the fact that it does only have three bedrooms. Mm. That would suit me, but clearly it isn't just my decision.
No.
So it depends how much Caroline manages to sway her father.
I mean, I can certainly arrange a meeting with an architect if you want. You would, however, be looking at a build time of between 18 to 24 months, and you'd also be looking at having building work going on around you for the foreseeable future.
Yeah, I understand that.
But it's a lot to think about, and, you know, I don't envy your task. You know, do you think it's worth waiting 18 months to 2 years to get the property of your dreams, when you could actually move into...
In a few months' time.
Yeah, but that isn't the property of your dreams. It's not my dreams, I'm being honest.
Well, if it was only my choice, then yes, I'd be tempted to go for the one we've just seen and move in the next few months.
Right.
But clearly, to be fair, I've got to consider what Keith and the girls would like too.
It's a really tough decision, and Julie looks more confused than I've ever seen her. I almost feel guilty for showing them a fourth option.
No, you see, I love bathrooms like this, and kitchens very modern and clean.
I think you're just stuck when you're asking.
I'm not keen on the living area in the dining
room. I think it's gorgeous.
Looks like a conference room in an office.
That's where Dad would love it.
Well, I'm trying to get him away from the office.
Yeah, but he'd be more inclined to come. You're just stuck.
That's lovely.
But Julie, that's the joy of building your own. The ideas all come from you.
Crikey, this is getting interesting, isn't it? Throughout this property search, I've had the feeling that it's always been about what Julie wants, and the property that we've just come from is her to a T. However, going around this one now, it's becoming quite obvious that Caroline and Stephanie and Keith would love this.
This is so tough. After waiting 2 years for one cracking home, I've given them an agonising choice of two. Both fantastic, each offering different pluses and minuses for the whole family. But they've got to decide fast. Both options are attracting serious interest. There's going to be a big phone bill for Julie and a sleepless night for us all.
So, ladies, bit of a whirlwind. Let me go through the properties. House on Hill and the old Portuguese house, the first two that we looked at. Absolute no-nos.
Absolute no-nos.
OK. Well, that just leaves the two properties in Val de Lobo. Now, I have to admit, the three-bed house with the views, when we walked into that and you were like, that's it, this is it, this is it, I want this one, I was like, brilliant, done deal. I was convinced that that was the one for you and that nothing was going to make you change your mind. And then we looked at the plot of land and then we looked at the really big, flash, swanky glass house. And towards the end of that, when I left you there, you looked like you were in a real quandary.
Yes, it's been a really, really difficult decision because when we saw the three-bed villa, I knew even before I walked up the drive it was going to be right, and it was absolutely beautiful. But having looked at the plot, I can see that that's got a lot of potential.
If you go for the three-bedroom house that's already built, you have to put a 10% deposit down. Now, If you change your mind or pull out for any reason, you will lose that 10% deposit. If the seller changes his mind and doesn't sell to you, they have to give you 20% back, which I think is such a good idea. With the plot of land, you have to make a decision now because there's a waiting list and they'll only hold it for the rest of the day.
OK, well, we can arrange for the deposit for the land to be transferred from England today.
So you're going to go for the land?
We are.
Fantastic news. But as there's been plenty of people buzzing after this place, even with its £1.5 million asking price, I need to close the deal. After 2 years of waiting, I'd hate for them to lose out now.
Hello, it's Amanda. How are you? I'm very well, thank you. Listen, I've got some good news. We would like to put an offer, please, for the plot. Full asking price. I know. Could you get back to me as soon as possible, please? That's lovely. Thank you very much. Thanks a lot. Bye. They're just going to talk to the management company and get back to us in 2 minutes. Did you think when you started this search that you would find something or not?
I didn't think about a plot, I have to say. I thought it was going to be a property. And it took me by surprise, really, to see that plot earlier.
And Caroline, when Mum and Dad have their big, flash, swanky pad right on the wall, did you think you'll be coming out to Portugal a bit more often?
Oh, definitely, especially, yeah.
I mean, in a way, it's going to be great, because I guess now you... Well, hopefully, you've secured the plot. You can start really working with the architect, and all four of you, I guess, can have an input, can't you?
And the nice thing is that there's not going to be a rush. I think if we were buying the three-bed villa, I would want to move sooner rather than later. Oh.
Hello. Hello. Hi, Michael. Perfect. That's fantastic. Thank you very much. We'll be in touch shortly regarding deposits and things. Brilliant. Thank you. Bye-bye. Bye. You got it. I'm going to come around this huge table and give you a hug. Congratulations. You are going to get to hear the sea. Well
thank
done, you. And you can get to come out.
Thank you.
Well done. Wow. That's incredible. You're done. And now you've done it. I mean, that's it. You will be able to go to sleep in about 2 years' time and listen to that. It's going to be incredible.
After 2 years of dreaming, their fairy tale house will soon be theirs. I love a happy ending.